Hello, Indiana 4-H broadband influencers. Let's check our internet speeds. So the first thing you need to do is go to the Indiana broadband testing site, which is called connectingindiana.com, and click on test your internet. The easiest thing to do, you can either type your address in or click on current location. And it will eventually load. Click on next. Tell it whether you are plugged into your internet router, whether you're using Wi-Fi, or whether you're using cellular. Now, if you're using a cellular fixed hotspot, then go ahead and test your internet. If you are using just a cellular hotspot off of your phone, then you don't really have to bother doing this if that's all you have access to in your location, because it automatically counts as not having service. So go ahead and choose what you have, and tell it if you choose Wi-Fi, it will ask if you're as close as possible to your Wi-Fi router. I'm not, so I'm not going to check that. And then it's going to ask if I'm connected to a VPN. A VPN stands for Virtual Private Network, and they are often used to direct or safely exchange information in a business setting. So oftentimes students are not connected. If you are, go ahead and say yes or disconnect. I am not connected, so I'm going to say no. And is anyone on your network currently on a video call? Are they streaming videos? Are they gaming? Basically, is your internet being used heavily? In my house, it is pretty much always yes. And go ahead and say yes. So before we begin, it's going to eventually ask you on the next few pages what tier of internet service you have. I'm going to go ahead and start my test. It's going to ask you what tier of internet service you have. And basically the reason it's asking that is just to see, and so they can kind of record that and track that. Right now I am reporting from my home, and I have what is called fixed wireless. If you have cable, DSL is a little bit slower than cable, but not a lot. Fiber is super fast. Fixed wireless, kind of slow. Satellite is fast, but not super duper consistent and stable. And this actually, if you have satellite, this won't count for as part of this initiative. It's considered not being served. And go ahead and hit next there. Then it's going to ask you what tier of service you're subscribed to. Now this you can usually tell by looking at your bill, and sometimes you have to compare your bill to your provider's website. That's kind of what I did. I looked at how much I'm paying per month, and then I was able to say, well, if I'm paying this much per month, then their website says this is what tier of service I'm getting. So in my case, I happen to know that they are telling me that my download speeds are here and my upload speeds are here, 51 to 100 and upload is 0 to 10. That is not going to be the case for everybody. And it's not always super easy to tell what that is. In theory, it should be on your bill, but like I said, sometimes you just have to go to their website and do some comparison and investigation. And someone else in your house might know too. Then click next. And are you paying for the highest tier of service available from your provider? And that same thing, you have to look at your bill and their website and kind of figure it out. Or maybe you already know. I already know. So I'm going to go ahead and say yes. And on average, how many devices at your location use the internet at the same time? That may or may not be accurate. And that may or may not be accurate. So how many people in my house are students? How many people in my house are senior citizens? And how many people in my house work from home? And next through that, and how many people can use your current internet as it is right this very second without any stalling, long delays, waits, things like that? That's probably generous. and say next. And does anyone at your location use the internet to complete school assignments or job training courses or work? And say yes or no. My guess is if you're a 4-H-er, you're probably also doing school assignments on your home internet. So now this part is going to take a little bit. And while it is running, let's talk about the ways that you can take a screenshot, because at the end, I'm going to suggest, and you don't have to, but it is a very solid choice. I'm going to suggest that you take a screenshot of your results. And to do that, if you have a Mac, press Shift Command 3, and that will take a screenshot. And if you have a PC, you have a couple different options. Probably you'll have a snipping tool or Snip and Sketch or Snagit or something like that, and you can take a screenshot that way. If you're running it on your phone, which really isn't going to give you great results, then just do a standard screenshot. Or if you're running it on, well, although if your phone is connected to your Wi-Fi, it still would give you good results. Sorry. If you're running it or a tablet or something, just do a standard screenshot like you usually do and save that image. If you don't have internet, that's the one thing that I forgot to say. If you have no internet at all and it isn't working, go ahead and text internet to INDY 464699, and then they will know that you don't have internet at your location, and it will help. And I think those are all the things that I wanted to share with you, and perfect timing. And apparently I'm unknown. Yesterday I was unserved. So these are my results. It didn't come up with any download speed. It didn't come up with any upload speed, which is a concern. And basically I need to take this screenshot and save it. So I am going to screenshot that and save it. And then on our next video, we will upload that to the FCC National Broadband map. Thank you so much for all of your efforts.